Hello everyone. I hope you all are safe and healthy at your home, washing your hands and not going out. I, Ms. Gunjan Dasmani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota, welcome you all to the e-learning classes of English grammar. And today we are going to do the chapter of your English grammar book, that is Grammar Way, chapter number 16, that is subject verb agreement. You can open your books to page number 76 and you will find this chapter on that page number. Okay, so first, in the previous video we have seen what was the subject and predicate, and now in this video we will see subject verb agreement. That means how the subject and the verb agrees with each other to make the sentence meaningful. Okay, so I'll tell you some of the examples and some of the rules of agreement that we should follow while we are writing a sentence. Okay, so I am writing a sentence to make you understand how does the subject agrees with the verb. Okay, if I write, he plays football, and one more sentence I am writing, that is they play football. Okay, over here you can see the subjects of both the sentences are different. Okay, so you can see if the subject is singular, the verb will always be singular. That is, both the subject and the verb will be singular. Subject is singular, verb also singular. Okay, this is the singular verb. It is having S because that is why it is coming with the singular subject. That is why this is a singular verb. Okay, and they is the plural subject. It is, the subject over here is plural, and the verb followed by it, that is play, it is also plural. Okay, so if the subject is singular, the verb will be singular. If the subject is plural, then the verb will be also plural. Okay, remember this thing. Now I will tell you some of the rules of agreement that we should follow while writing a sentence. Okay, there are some of the rules written on page number 76 of your book. Okay, you can see on page number 76. So I will start with some of the rules for subject verb agreement. Rules, and the rule number one is what? When the subject of a sentence is composed of two or more nouns or pronouns joined by an, the verb is plural. Okay, so what I am telling you is when the subject of a sentence is having two or nouns or pronouns. Let's suppose if I say Riya and Sneha . As I said, that when the subject of sentence is composed of two or more nouns or pronouns joined by and. These are two nouns joined by and, isn't it? So what we will use? The verb would be plural. We will use the plural verb because we are having two nouns used. Okay, we are having two nouns, that is Riya and Sneha. That is why what we will use? I will use are, okay, are best friends, okay. This is the first rule that you should follow. Moving to the second rule, what is the second rule? Let's see the second rule. When the subject consists of two singular nouns joined by and express a single idea, the verb is singular. Okay, when the subject consists of two singular nouns, when we are talking about two singular nouns and they are also joined by and they express what? They express a same thought, or I can say the same idea, or a single idea, then the verb would be singular. The verb will not be plural, the verb will be singular. The verb used over there would be singular. I'm writing the sentence. You can see. Butter and cheese. Okay? Butter and cheese joined by and. Two singular nouns joined by and. Okay? Express a single idea, or a same thought. That is, I'm writing a dash because I will tell you what verb you should put in this sentence. Okay? Harmful, for health. Okay? So, in this blank, what will come? Is or are? As I told you that these two things are expressing the same idea, single idea. That is why I will use is with it. Okay? Now, moving to the next point. That is the rule number third. What is the rule number third? When two singular nouns are joined by an and refer to the same person, the verb is singular. When we are referring to the same person, okay, that these two things are there, these two nouns are there, and they two nouns are referring to the single person only. Okay, that time the verb will be singular. Let's suppose I'll give you an example. That is, the actor and singer dash very popular among youth. Okay, here what I have to put? I'll put is or are, because the actor and singer refers to the same person. Let's suppose if I'm talking about myself. I am only the actor and I am only the singer. Okay, the actor and singer refers to me only. That is the same person, the single person. That is why what I will put is the actor and singer. What will come? Is will come, because it refers to the same person, isn't it? Okay, now moving to the fourth point, the fourth rule that is there, that is, when the definite article the is used with two singular nouns to refer to two persons, the verb is plural. Okay, when the sentence is having definite articles used with the two singular nouns, okay, to refer to the two persons. Like if I say, look at the example. The painter and the singer are modest in behavior. Okay, over here, what you can see that painter is used and singer is used. These are two singular nouns used with the article the. We have used the definite article the over here, isn't it? Before painter also and before singer also, we have used the article the. Okay, so when the article is used with the nouns, with the singular nouns, and that is joined by and, so then what we will use, the verb will be plural. We will use the plural verb. Okay, that is why I have used are, not is. Okay, now I am moving to the fifth point. That is rule number five. That is, when two or more singular nouns or pronouns are joined by or nor, the verb is singular. When I am joining two singular nouns with or nor, okay, like if I say Sita or Geeta, okay, Sita or Geeta. That is, these are two singular nouns, isn't it? They are singular nouns and they are joined by or. So what I will use with them? The singular verb. Okay, I'll use the singular verb over here because we have put or just to choose among them, isn't it? Either one of them will be doing the work. Okay, इसीलिए हम यहाँ पे क्या यूज करेंगे? We will use the verb that the singular verb that is has arranged the books properly. Okay, that is why I have used has, not have. Okay, now moving to the sixth rule, don't get confused over here. If now when a singular and a plural noun or a pronoun are joined by or nor, here also we are joining with or, but what are we joining? Two singular nouns. Here I will join a singular noun with the plural noun with the help of what? Or nor. Okay, here we were just joining two singular nouns. And in the next rule, that is rule number 6, you can see on page number 77 of your book. Okay, I am joining a singular noun with the plural noun. Okay, if I say the magazines or the book. Okay, what verb I will use, I will tell you later, but first I will write the full sentence, that is been borrowed from the library. Okay, over here you can see that I am joining magazines, which is what? Which is a plural noun, isn't it? And with a singular noun, that is book. I am joining magazines and book with the help of what? Or. This is plural, this is singular. Okay? And I have joined it with the help of or. Okay? Or I can say if I joined with them with nor also. Okay? Then what noun I will use? What verb I will use with them? What verb will be used? The verb agrees with the subject closer to the verb. Here the verb will come which is close to this subject, isn't it? Ye blank jo hai, yahan par verb aayega aur ye kisse close hai? Isse close hai. Theek hai? Is subject se close hai. So hum इसी के अकॉर्डिंग यहाँ पर ब्लैंक फिल करेंगे. यहाँ पर जो वर्ब होगा वो किससे एग्री करेगा? इट विल एग्रीज इट द वर्ब विल एग्री विद द सब्जेक्ट क्लोजर टू द वर्ब. ओके, सो दिस इज सिंगुलर, देन दिस विल ऑल्सो बी सिंगुलर. सो आई विल यूज हैज, नॉट हैव. इफ आई से दैट मैं यहाँ पर मैगजीन कर दूँ और मैं यहाँ पर बुक्स कर दूँ. ओके, इफ मैंने यहाँ पे क्या किया? मैंने यहाँ पर बुक्स कर दिया. सो यहाँ पर ये जो है, ये ब्लैंक जो वर्ब आएगा वो इसी सब्जेक्ट से एग्री करेगा क्योंकि ये ब्लैंक किसके पास है? इस वर्ब के पास है, इजंट इट? तो मैं यहाँ पर हैव का यूज करूँगी, ठीक है? नॉट हैज. ओके, दिस विल वेरीज लाइक दैट. ओके, नाउ मूविंग टू द सेवेंथ रूल. ओके, सेवेंथ रूल क्या है? लेट्स सी इन योर बुक ऑल्सो यू कैन सी. Okay, keep your book with you whenever you are watching the videos. Okay, the words each one, either, neither, everyone, everybody, anybody, anyone, nobody, somebody, someone, and no one are singular and requires a singular verb. Okay, with these words that I have told you, that each, everyone, each, every, or I can say each one, neither, everybody, anybody, someone, somebody, with them we will use what? They are singular, so we will use the singular verb with them. Okay, I'm writing one more example. You can see someone was hurt during the game. Okay, here I have used the word someone, which is what? Which is singular. Okay, this word is singular. So that is why I have used the singular verb with it, that is was, not were. Okay, so with the words like this, we will use the singular verb only. Okay, now moving to the next rule, that is rule number 8. When two subjects are joined by either or, neither nor, the verb agrees with the second subject in number or person. Okay, we will agree with the second subject over there, because it will have two subjects, because we are joining two nouns over here, that is with the help of either or neither nor. Okay, so if I write neither Tom nor George dash leaving. Okay, so you can see there are two subjects, that is Tom and George. Okay, so we have to see the second subject, because the verb will agree with the second subject. Okay, over here, whenever we are using neither nor or either or, with them, the verb will agree with the second subject over there. So it is what? It is singular. So we will also use the singular verb, that is. Okay, इसीलिए हम किसे refer करेंगे? इसे रेफर करेंगे बिकॉज ये सेकेंड सब्जेक्ट है, एंड इसीलिए हमने क्या लिखा? इज लिखा. अगर मैं यहाँ पर ऐसा बोलती नीदर टॉम नॉर हिज फ्रेंड्स, ओके हिज फ्रेंड्स वुड हैव कम, देन यहाँ पर जो वर्ब होता वो सेकेंड जो सब्जेक्ट है वो होता हिज फ्रेंड्स, इजंट इट. तो हम यहाँ पर क्या यूज करते? वी हैव यूज्ड, वी विल हैव यूज्ड आर इन प्लेस ऑफ इज. ओके, नाउ मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट रूल, रूल नंबर 9. When two subjects are joined by as well as or with, the verb agrees with the first subject in number or person. Okay, when the subject is joined by as well as or with, like if I say the manager, comma, as well as his secretary, comma, dash, speaking very confidently. Okay, over here what I have to use is, you have seen the manager as well as, we have used as well as over here. Okay, when the sentence is, when the two subjects are joined by as well as or with. With the help of with. Okay, you have joined two subjects, that is manager and a secretary, isn't it? With the help of as well as. So, what we will just see the first subject over here. Okay, jahan par hum as well as ya with use kar rahe hain, we will see the first subject, that is manager, which is the first subject over here, and this is singular, so the verb will be singular. Okay, so verb bhi kya hoga? Singular. To yahan pe aa jayega is. Okay. अगर मान लो यहाँ पर मैं सब्जेक्ट चेंज कर दूँ, इफ आई मेक द सब्जेक्ट प्लूरल, फर्स्ट सब्जेक्ट पे प्लूरल कर दूँ, तो वर्ब भी प्लूरल हो जाएगा. ओके, इन प्लेस ऑफ इज व्हाट विल कम? आर विल कम. ओके, लाइक दिस. नाउ मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट रूल, दैट इज रूल नंबर 10th. व्हाट इज रूल नंबर 10th? नाउन्स सच एज सिविक्स, मैथमेटिक्स, मीजल्स एंड न्यूज रिक्वायर सिंगुलर वर्ब्स. ओके, लाइक इफ आई से मैथमेटिक्स, ओके दिस इज a particular subject, isn't it? So, and but it is having S, doesn't make it plural, because that's the whole subject over here. So, mathematics or jo words S se end ho rahe hain, like civics is there, that is also a particular subject, isn't it? Measles, this is kind of particular disease, okay? अलग अलग diseases थोड़ी हैं या अलग अलग maths थोड़ी होती है, particular एक subject है maths, isn't it? So, mathematics is there. If I use mathematics, तो हम क्या करेंगे? Is इज आएगा क्योंकि ये पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट है. दैट इज़ वाई द वर्ड्स दैट आर लाइक मैथमेटिक्स और सिविक्स वी विल यूज द सिंगुलर वर्ब विद इट. ओके, सो इसीलिए हम यहाँ पे पुट करेंगे इज ईजी, इज एन ईजी सब्जेक्ट फॉर सम पीपल. Okay, I have used is over here. Okay, now moving to the next rule, that is rule number 11. Let's see what is the rule number 11. Nouns such as scissors, tweezers, spectacles, trousers and shears require plural verbs. Okay, they are what? This is, if I say as one scissors, there is only one scissor. That is why I will use scissors with it. We have studied them when we have studied singular and plural nouns over there, isn't it? When we were forming the plural nouns out of the singular nouns, at that time we have seen these words like scissors. The scissors matlab ek hi scissor hoga beta. Okay, for one scissor or four more than one scissors. Okay, I will use this one word, that is scissors. Okay, now with these kind of words the verb will be plural. Okay, so I am writing these trousers are too tight. Okay, over here I have used the verb, that is are. Okay, I'll use with these kind of words like scissors, trousers, shears. So what I'll use, we'll use are with them. Okay, now moving to the next rule. Okay, I'm coming to the next rule. Now moving to the next rule, that is rule number 12 rule is, in sentences beginning with there is or there are, the subject follows the verb. Since there is and there are is not the subject, the verb agrees with what follows. Okay, so I'll give you an example and I will make you understand this line. That is, if I am using there dash many problems to be resolved. Okay, over here if I am using there is or there are in the sentence, here there is not the subject. In the there and or I can say here, there is not the subject in the sentence. In the sentence that is beginning with there is not the subject, it will come afterwards. Okay, wo baad mein aayega, subject baad mein hoga. ठीक है, तो हम यहाँ पर क्या करेंगे, वॉट वी विल यूज इज, यहाँ पर हम किसे फॉलो करेंगे, यहाँ पर हम देखेंगे सब्जेक्ट को, दैट इज यहाँ पर मैनी प्रॉब्लम्स है. ओके, दैट इज वाई हम आर यूज करेंगे. ओके, इफ आई से देयर डैश वन प्रॉब्लम फॉर अस टू सॉल्व, इट इज देयर. इफ यहाँ पर मैं वन लिख दूँ मैनी की जगह, तो यहाँ पर इन प्लेस ऑफ आर वॉट विड कम इज विल कम. ओके, so you have to remember this thing. Okay, now moving to the next rule, that is rule number 13. Okay, collective nouns generally take a singular verb if they are considered as an entity. Okay, like collective noun will generally use a singular verb with them. Okay, like if I say the committee dash on the quality of the writing. Okay, over here Over here, what I will use? Agree or agrees? What I should use in this sentence? I will use the singular verb, that is agrees. I will use agrees, okay? Not agree, okay? Because these collective, this is a collective noun, okay? So, with collective nouns, we will use the singular verb, okay? Now, moving to rule number 14, that is the last rule. Sometimes the subject of a sentence is a phrase, okay? The verb agrees with the subject and not with the noun or pronoun in the phrase. Over here, what we should see is when the subject of a sentence, when the subject of the sentence is a phrase, like if I write the sentence, one of the bags dash open. Okay, so here this is the subject, which is what? Which is a phrase. Okay, it is not a singular, it's not a single word, it's a phrase. Okay, so with phrase, the verb will agree with the subject, not with the noun or a pronoun in the subject. वो किससे agree, किससे करेगा बेटा? Verb किससे agree करेगा? Subject से, ना कि noun या pronoun से. Okay, so ये है, तो इसीलिए हम क्या करेंगे? One of the bags, यानी कि एक इन bags में से एक bag, ठीक है? एक ही bag की बात की जा रही है, तो इसीलिए हम यहाँ क्या use करेंगे? Is, that is the singular, that it will be the singular verb, okay? इसीलिए हमने यहाँ पे is use किया, okay? So these are some of the rules that we have studied in this chapter. Now we will move to the exercise of this chapter. Moving to the book work of this chapter, that is exercise number A. Fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets, and one has already been done for you. So now I'll take another example, another sentence, that is second one, that is either my bag or my shoes dash always missing. Okay, so I have told you with either or we will refer to the second subject. The verb will agree with the second subject, that is the second subject is what? Shoes. That is why we have used are over here. If in place of shoes, that would be bag. Okay, so I have used is with it. Okay, but as I am using shoes, which is the second subject over here, so that is why I have used what? Are. Because with either or neither nor, we use the second, the verb will agree with the second subject. Okay, so now I'll take one another example, that is seventh number. Every contestant dash called upon the stage. As I have told you that everybody, everyone, like this here, every is used, isn't it? So with what? Every is there. So every yahan par use hua hai. Like I have told you that every, someone, somebody, or no one. With these words are what? These words are singular. So we will use singular verb with it. That is why I have used is with it, not are. This is correct. Okay? Is will come in this blank. Okay? Now moving to the B exercise. Okay? Now moving to the B exercise, I am taking, what is this B exercise? Rewrite these sentences correctly. Okay? I am taking the fifth one, that is one of the books in this collection are valuable. These are the wrong sentences written. We need to correct them and we have to rewrite them again, okay? By correcting them, okay? So, as I have told you, here what is the subject? One of the books is there, okay? One of the books is used, okay? So, one of the books, that is a phrase, okay? So, when the subject of a sentence is a phrase, okay, we will see the verb will always agrees with what? Will agrees with the subject and not with the noun or a pronoun, okay? So, here one is there. That is why in place of are, what should come? Is should come. So, one of the books in this collection is valuable. I have used is. I have corrected this sentence. This is what? This is wrong. This is the correction and I have corrected over here and I have used is. Okay? Now moving to the C exercise. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the words in bracket and use the present tense. One has been done for you. Okay? We are given the words in the brackets and we have to put the correct verb in the sentence and we have to use the present tense only. Okay? So I am taking the second one, that is the guitarist and singer. Okay? Here the guitarist and singer refer to the same person. Okay? That is why I will use singular verb with it. So that is why verb is given to us respond, and the singular verb that would be used would be response. Okay? So the answer is response. Okay? So now this was C exercise. Rest you have to do like this only that I have told you. And moving to the E exercise, your next exercise, that is each of these sentences has an error. Okay? In all the sentences there is an error. What we have to do is we need to underline the error and write the correct word in the blanks given. Okay? What we have to do is we have to underline the error and then we have to write the corrected word over here in this blank. Okay? I am taking the third one over here, that is Varun as well as his friend were listening attentively to the announcement. What is the error? Were is the error because I have told you that when we are joining the nouns with as well as or with, okay, the verb will agree with the first subject. Okay, as I am having two subjects over there, there are two subjects, isn't it? So the verb will agree with the first subject, that is Varun, and Varun is singular, so I have to use was in place of were. So I will write was over here. I have written was over here, isn't it? And were is the wrong one. So I have underlined this. Okay. I will underline this one. Okay. And I will write was over here because this is the corrected word. Okay. In this way only you have to do this exercise. I hope you have understood this chapter well. Stay fit. Stay at your home. Thank you.